Well, so today I will talk a little bit about my own online projects that I'm trying to set up, maintain, grow, build, make explode, so I can make my living online. So, what kind of projects are we dealing with? Well, the first project I started was a few months ago, and this was together with my lovely wife, as I had the idea to try to find a way to sell her artwork online and actually make money from this. Now, you all know the expression starving artist, and usually it's very true. So I thought, how can I make this starving to become unstarving? So with this, we follow the concept that we would work with specific color palettes. For example, because as we were focusing on paintings to hang inside, we thought, we should match this with colors that people actually put in their rooms. So this was the idea, and then after some months we came with some pickled situations. Anyway, long story short, we are now focusing more on different products, for example bags or pillows. We will introduce more clothing because it seems that the wearable art is a lot more popular than the hanging art. So let's check the progress today. Oh, did I share the name? So the name is Blushbird. Funny story actually, Blushbird was a name that I picked to do wedding photography, you know, because it's cute and romantic. But then I actually never started this business very seriously, but I already bought a domain. So then we thought, like maybe my wife is the Blushbird. Anyways, here is the website. So we have a nice landing image to show that this is more like an artistic website. You can go straight to the shop, because if people just want to buy, please just buy. Then we have a small introduction video, which you can view online. It's very basic, to be honest. I didn't go crazy with this. I still plan to make a really nice introduction video, but as everything, professional things take a lot of time. So then we also have a connected blog, we have our shop, and then if you are interior designer, you can partner with us. Still, if you want to work with the more original idea, we can cooperate and participate into making amazing inside art. So, of course, we should build our email list, because that's how we can communicate with our, you know, people who like our stuff. So, join the flock, get to know our promotions and discover our new artwork. So, as I mentioned before, we have these color palettes. We still like this idea because it also, you know, reflects on the personality of the person. For example, here we have Beachy Palette. This is all the colors that the Beachy Palette uses. Then you can see an example. This is from the Rhodes collection. Then we have a whole bunch of different color palettes. So on the bottom I have some small text. This is mainly for the CEO. We have a lot of really good keywords that we think would benefit from Google search. We also added a bunch of hashtags. And then we added again links to other pages on the website, because this is something that Google appreciates. So our little footer, contact information, again the menu, and then again a sign up form. So let's just go to the shop. So as you can see, at the moment we have pillows, canvases, prints and bags. And then our customer reviews. So let me tell a little bit. When we started this shop, we didn't really promote this in the big way. From the beginning we thought, let's just build this organically. We are not in a rush, because this is more of my wife's personal art. It's not a very commercial idea, but we are trying to commercialize it. So how we started is we reached out to friends and family. We gave them a discount so that they would order some products. Then we asked them, please leave us a review, because social proofing is very important. So social proofing is make sure that other people like it or use it or buy it, because people like what other people do. This is just how it works. So if you have an empty shop with no social proofing, it could be a ghost shop, you know, who knows? knows? It could be just a fraud, a fake, a scam, whatever. Anyways, now we have reviews from friends and family on here. At the moment we build up 18 reviews. And I think this will help us be more trusted by people online. So then we have a couple of Rene favorites works, and then again we have everything organized per color palette. But this is just a homepage, so if we want to go more specific, we can go to the shop. Let's say I am looking for a bag. So then you have a nice overview. Oh, let me say, so this shop platform we use for Blushbird is Shopify. I think Shopify is really nice if you have a large amount of products. It really does an amazing job organizing all products, organizing categories. The interface is really nice. But the downside of Shopify is that it can get pricey. So from the start, you have like minimum $30 US that you need to pay just to use their system. Then if you want to upgrade some things, you need to go to the higher plan. Also on Shopify, a lot of the plugins are paid and a little bit pricey. So Shopify is good if you know you're going to sell product, or if you have a really big shop and these costs are, you know, just part of the business. So mainly we use Shopify with Blushbird because we have a large amount of products. So for example, I think now we have 80-90 different designs, and then every design we have in the four different products. And for example, in prints and canvases, we have different sizes of each design as well. So in the end, it's a lot of variations, a lot of heavy data stuff, and this is something that Shopify can handle. So here we can choose again between the products, between the different color palettes. Then we have some different collections, for example the roads that you could see on our homepage. So for example, this is just classic Shopify look, where you have your small things. Oh, then a little bit about the plugins that I use. So I did a lot of research, I did a lot of trial and error with the plugins that I wanted. For example, I wanted a chat app, so if people have a question about a certain product, they can just go on chat with us. Hi there! And then this is my face. So, ready to help. Hello! So then another little plugin where I thought, oh, you know, I'm more also connected to the social proofing. If people like what we do, we want to give them points for things they do. For example, like us on Facebook or Instagram, or share something, or even if they have a birthday, we will give them points. If they send a referral or link to a friend and the friend buys something, they will also get points, and in the end with these points they can get a discount. So about the products, everything is dropshipping. So what happens is we work together with the company Printful. Anyone can work together with them. You can just sign up and start dropshipping your designs. So what we do is it's connected with Shopify, and then automatically all the products from Printful will be shown into Shopify. You have to upload your designs into Printful, make sure everything is okay, and then they'll go on your shop. Something I haven't shown, oh, the blog. So the blog is also for trying to get more in the Google ranking, because there is a lot of content or changing content, a lot of words, a lot of keywords that is connected to our business and style. So this should all really help to have more content online. And when you have more content and optimized content and renewing content, this will just get you up in the search results. So here you can see a couple of the blogs that we have. So this is where we are at with Blushbird. So let's say we started this a couple of months. It took me a long time to get all the different products in the shop. I spend most of my time on this. Now I'm just kind of finding a way what is exactly our niche. So like I said, we want to focus more on wearable art, just being out there. So we are working on some smaller designs that we can put on t-shirts, other products. So what about the future? At the moment we are trying to mainly grow organically through our Instagram. Let me bump this up. So at the moment we are at almost 2500 followers. After a few months, with this shop, it is still pretty small in general, so we have a lot of growing to do, but as we do everything organically, it might take a little bit time. We are also still learning every day how to do things better, but for now we just go with consistency and then doing this for a long period of time and let it grow like this. You know, opportunities will come up, they will arise, as they say, and then, you know, everything will be fine. So let me quickly scroll through our Instagram. So you can see my wife mainly posts on certain color palettes. For example, this is all the Carefree color palette. At the moment we're actually doing a giveaway, so make sure to go on Instagram.com, look for blushbird.art and follow the instructions on the giveaway and you might win a free bag. Oh, other things on social media. So our Facebook, we don't really do too much. We just copy the paste from Instagram also to our Facebook. It's not our primary social audience, but we don't want to neglect Medium if we can just duplicate posts for free. And another thing we actually recently started to set up is our Pinterest, because we aim at millennials and Pinterest is very big with millennials. Okay, for some reason Pinterest and Safari don't like each other. So let's open Chrome, let's go to Pinterest. Okay, so now we are here on Pinterest. So, you know, this is still really small because we now just started to work on this. Let me just show you how it looks like. So for now we are just mainly showcasing our art. We made a little template for this, so you know the title, the palette that we are using, how to connect with us, and a little blush bird, just to brand the whole thing. So as you can see, a lot has been done to build this website and this web shop and to make everything, you know, proper, to grow on social media. So now we just have to keep going and see what happens. Anyways, don't forget to follow us as well. You can find everything on blushbird.com and from there you can just navigate your way through wherever you want to go. So thank you for watching. If you have any comments or questions, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Please do hit the bell, you know, because then you will know when a new video comes out. Anyways, thank you for watching. See you next time.